This is the most powerful. This is the most powerful. This is the most powerful AMD APU that you can buy right now. The Ryzen 7 5700G. It comes with new Zen 3 cores, but with the older Vega iGPU. If you're in Malaysia and you've been affected by the flood recently, my heart goes out to you. Semoga segalanya dipermudahkan. And if your PC has been destroyed by water damage and you need to build one quickly for work and even gaming, this could be the solution for you, because just like when we reviewed the Ryzen 5 5600G, GPU prices are still gila bubs. Also, I know we're a little bit late to the party, but I'm going to do some comparison tests that I haven't seen done so far with this processor, which is versus a mobile Ryzen 7 processor. Anyways, let's get cracking. The processor not inside, right?
It's inside!
Don't simply rise for anyone but your wife, see? Rhymes. Correct, ma. When your wife come home, you must stand up and greet her. Rise to the occasion. What are you thinking? Jangan terpesong. Don't simply like Hana f***. Just like the Ryzen 5 5600G, the Ryzen 7 5700G has been out since April for OEM markets and hit the shelves for DIY in August. To recap, we tested the Ryzen 5 5600G based on three categories, and here are our findings. Number one, for competitive players in titles like Valorant, it was excellent even against a discrete GPU like the GTX 1030. As a stopgap CPU, it is great with less than 10% performance loss against the Ryzen 5 5600X in CPU tasks. Again, in an ITX build for casual gaming and even as a media or content creator PC, work and play, it is also excellent. Now, the Ryzen 5 5600G can do all that with a $260 price tag. Can we say the same for the Ryzen 7 5700G at $360? It also only comes with the non-RGB Wraith self-cooler, which is a bummer. Also, I wanted to see how it compared to a laptop processor like a Ryzen 7 5800HS for pure CPU workloads, because I'm considering to build an ITX PC for our editor when we do get to go to Computex next, or anywhere that requires us to edit videos on the go. Anyways, let's dive into it. In terms of specs, the Ryzen 7 5700G comes with the Zen 3 architecture with 8 cores and 16 threads, 2 more cores than the Ryzen 5 5600G, and it also still has the same old Radeon Vega graphics, but we do get 8 CU here instead of 7 like on the Ryzen 5. Versus the 8 core pure CPU counterpart, again we get PCIe Gen 3 instead of Gen 4, and you're probably not gonna care too much about that if budget was a concern. Also, we get a slightly lower boost clock, the same half L3 cache at 16 MB because of the mix space on the die for the iGPU, but a very impressive 65W TDP, so you can probably stick to this non-RGB stock cooler if you want. It is also $90 cheaper at launch, which is definitely nothing to scoff at. Again, here are the specs to our test bench. Wrong one! For competitive players, we're looking to prioritize FPS with reasonable graphics in 720p and 1080p and maybe 1440p for some titles. I wanted to see if the Ryzen 7 5700G's performance against the Ryzen 5 5600G with its iGPU, as well as when paired with a GT 1030, can justify that $100 price difference. Especially for people who just want to build a gaming PC for Valorant and CSGO, or even MOBAs like LOL or Dota. For some reason, the Ryzen 7 5700G is performed slightly worse than the 5600G in CSGO with the iGPU, but performs about the same when paired with the GT 1030. In a newer title like Valorant, we are seeing pretty much the same numbers as the Ryzen 5 5600G. But curiously, while the Ryzen 5's iGPU performed better than the GT 1030, with the 5700G we're seeing higher FPS numbers on the GT 1030. I guess the Ryzen 7 5700G performs better as a CPU with better GPU performance scaling. Overall, both performed really well, giving us playable FPS with their iGPU, but the Ryzen 5 5600G is still the clear winner when it comes to value for money for competitive players.
Round 2!
as a stopgap CPU. This time we're pitching the Ryzen 7 5700G against the similarly 8-core Ryzen 7 5800X in pure CPU performance. Again, we are checking for any CPU bottlenecking should you choose the Ryzen 7 5700G as a temporary solution while waiting for GPU prices to come down. This only makes sense if you one, don't already have a usable GPU, like maybe a Radeon 5000 series or GTX 1000 series or RTX 2000 series and newer. And number two, you're not planning to get a GPU for at least 6 to 12 months and need to use the PC right now. We're also going to compare the Ryzen 7 5700G against the Ryzen 7 5800HS in CPU benchmarks to see how much more powerful it is versus a comparable laptop CPU. Now in these tests, we are looking at pretty much the same pattern when comparing the Ryzen 5 5600G versus the 5600X. The X series CPUs with double the L3 cache is definitely going to give us more performance when it comes to pure CPU scores. In Cinebench, while the Ryzen 5600G performed within 6-7% worse than the 5600X, things look different when comparing the Ryzen 7 5700G versus the 5800X. In R20, while it had similar scores in single core, in multi-threaded tests we are looking at an 11.5% difference. In R23, things seem to be reversed. The same can be seen in 3D Mark tests where the Ryzen 7 5800X just pulls quite a bit ahead when paired with a higher end card like the RTX 3080, especially in higher resolutions. We're looking at 18-22% performance loss, which is quite a bit. In actual gaming, things seem a little bit better. While a CPU-bound title like Valorant or Shadow of Tomb Raider would still show us a double-digit percentage drop in FPS, in GPU-bound titles like Red Dead Redemption or Doom, we are looking at only a 5% drop, which means that the Ryzen 7 5700G is still pretty good as a stopgap CPU. For productivity tasks, the 5700G is slightly better than the 5600G and only slightly worse than the 5800X for content creation. In 3D work, however, the Ryzen 7 5700G is quite a bit better than the 5600G. When compared to the Ryzen 7 5800H laptop processor, the results are pretty surprising. Other than Time Spy, we're only looking at a 1-5% performance increase on the Ryzen 7 APU over the laptop Ryzen 7. Now, unless you're gonna chuck a GPU into your PC in the near future, it seems that a Ryzen-powered laptop should also be considered as maybe an alternative to waiting for GPU prices to drop. Round 3, for a work and play all-in-one ITX PC. Finally, for content creators who also want to game a little in an all-in-one solution, we're talking about 4K video editing, photo editing, as well as potentially some gaming in AAA titles with reasonable graphics settings. The Ryzen 5 5600G already did a decent job here. I just wanted to see if those extra cores in the Ryzen 7 5700G can actually make a difference here. We saw the Ryzen 5 5600G kick the GT 1030s behind when it comes to higher end titles. The same can be seen here. In Time Spy, we see quite a significant bump in CPU scores over the Ryzen 5. This is reflected in the Shadow of Tomb Raider numbers at 1080p, where we're looking at a 45% increase in frames per second. Now these numbers seem to vary quite a bit depending on the title, so we should probably take it with a grain of salt. In productivity tasks, the Ryzen 7 5700G is still quite a bit better than the 5600G for content creation. I guess if I'm building an ITX PC for our next on-the-go editing PC, I'm probably picking the Ryzen 7 5700G. So we decided to skip on memory tests this round because preliminary tests showed the same observations as when we did it with the Ryzen 5 5600G. Basically, frequency or speed is more important than memory timing when it comes to the integrated GPU, while looser timing will reduce overall CPU performance. So just get whatever is the cheapest to keep your entire build's cost low, as long as it's at least 3000-3200MHz. To recap, here are the pros, meh, and cons of the Ryzen 7 5700G. I give the Ryzen 7 5700G a better for content creators, hashtag cheap buy 8 out of 10. Overall, most of my observations about the Ryzen 5 5600G is still true here, except at a considerably worse value. Number one, for competitive players, I gave it an 8 out of 10 because the Ryzen 5 5600G is still better value here at $100 cheaper. As a stopgap CPU, I give it also an 8 out of 10 because the price to performance ratio is still pretty good versus the Ryzen 7 5800X. And as an ITX casual gaming media content creator all in one PC, I also gave it an 8 out of 10 because it's still very all-rounded, especially if you need those extra cores for CPU-dependent tasks. But do at least put in 16GB of RAM if you want to edit videos on this thing. So, I think the Ryzen 7 5700G is still more a niche product compared to the Ryzen 5 5600G because I would only recommend it for people who need more CPU performance for tasks like content creation. For most of you guys, just pick the Ryzen 5 5600G instead for 80 to 90% of the same performance at 67.5% of the cost. What a good value, right? And that is everything I have to say about the Ryzen 7 5700G. If you thought this video was helpful in any way, feel free to like and share, and also leave a comment down below if you have any questions regarding this processor or any other processors or any processes in your life, and I'll try my best to reply to you. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on more content like this, and also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok recently so that we can TikTok about it. And I'll see you, Space Cowboy. Hey, wait, cancel already.